multiplying and dividing rational numbers, a la Shmoop. It's Samantha Stockwell's first day on the job, and they've already thrown her to the wolves. Ah, there we are. Even still, Sam hasn't been given much instruction, just that she's supposed to take all the numbers in the stockroom, multiply together the ones in the red boxes, and divide the ones in the blue box. She doesn't even want to think about what awaits her in the green box. Oof. Well, she'll deal with that thing later. Okay, first things first. In the red box, she finds a 1, a 3, a negative 2, and a negative 5. She racks her brain to try to recall what they told her in that 5-minute training video. Oh, right. She multiplies the numbers together, first ignoring the negative signs. 1 times 3 times 2 times 5, in California anyway, is 30. Next, she counts the negative signs, and if there's an even number of them, they cancel out. But if there's an odd number of them, well, then the answer becomes negative. Well, she's got two negatives here, so they cancel. A negative times a negative is a positive, and the final answer is just positive 30. Well, Sam records the answer in her activity log and moves on. The next red box has just three numbers, negative 3, negative 4, and negative 10. So 3 times 4 is 12, times 10 is, 120. And there are three negative signs, so a definite negative answer here, right? Boom, she writes down negative 120 in the logbook and is on to the next. Sam's a bit nervous about the blue box, but she absolutely cannot lose her third job this month. She's not going back to Macy's, no way. And here she finds just two numbers, huh? Not so bad. Her instructions were to divide the smaller of the two numbers by the bigger one. So she has to take negative 15 and divide it by negative 2, keeping in mind that negative 15 is actually the smaller number. Well, 15 divided by 2 doesn't reduce, so she gets 15 halves, and the negatives cancel. So the answer is positive 15 halves. She barely broke a sweat on that one. But then the dreaded green box. There are about 200 numbers in there, and what's this? A zero? Really? Included in the box are instructions that she should divide every other number in the box by that ugly little zero. Well, Sam spends the rest of the afternoon trying to do so, but it ain't happening, folks. She tries it forwards, backwards, upside down, and sideways, and nada. Finally, it hits her. She's not able to do it because it can't be done. She hasn't felt this good about herself since she played hooky from World Lit and got away with it. All right, well, Sam writes undefined in the log and clocks out, calls it a day. She makes a mental note to take the south elevator tomorrow.